Good evening, everyone. My name is Edwin George. I'm at home reading my Bible. I was just going through some scriptures, you know, reading the book of Enoch. And the book of Jubilees, you know, I like to read. So I read these books. Listen, I'm not a Christian. I used to be a member of Trinity Pentecostal Church in LaSalle, okay? And before that, I went to so many different churches. Man, let me tell you something. You see, all these churches, the Pentecostal, the Seventh-day Adventist, the Jehovah Witness, I see all these churches as businesses, you know? These people are just trying to make money. These people really don't believe in God. I've been going to church from since I was a little kid growing up. Well, it's a little bit noisy here right now because I'm on my balcony, you know, and those big trucks passing Provo Street is very close to me, so it's gonna be a little bit noisy, and I don't want to move from here right now because I'm enjoying the breeze under my big umbrella, okay? But here, what's going on? These churches, what I noticed, these churches really don't teach the people nothing about God, you know. They don't tell you who you are. For so many years I've been to church, go to so many different churches, none of these preachers ever tell me who I am or where do I come from. We know we were brought here in the Americas as slaves, all right? But let me tell you guys something. I'm a strong believer in Christ. Regardless of what them do and say in the church, if you notice when you go to church, the preachers always dictate the sermon that they preach. The scriptures that they preach, and they never explain to the people who we really are and where we're from and all this kind of stuff. And I've been doing my own little research. Plus, there is this program that I love, you know, I think, and it's called the Gathering of Christ Church. Listen, these guys, the Most High really chose these guys to do what they're doing, because these guys speak the truth and they do a lot of work. They research a lot. And I listen to this, I watch these programs a lot from Brother Rocco and others, you know, from the Gathering of Christ Church. I'm encouraging you guys, you could go on YouTube and just check out the Gathering of Christ Church at AOL.com or something like that, I think. Just check out the Gathering of Christ Church. This is a good... These brothers really know what they're doing. They're preaching, they're spreading the word of the Most High, you know. The Most High waking up his people all around the world. Huh? Because I'm meeting a lot of people out there, and I'm talking to a lot of people. I'm telling you, the people are fed up with these churches. They're just ripping off the community. Every Sunday you're just giving them money. And what they're doing with the money, they're sending all the money over there to support these evil doers over in Israel who claiming to be Jews, and they are not Jews. They are not. Even the scriptures tell you these people are not. They steal our heritage, man. They have our books, our history, everything that they take when they chase us out of Israel in 70 AD, when we, as the scriptures say, we had to run into the wilderness, you know. You know, the wilderness that the scripture is talking about is really from Saudi Arabia all the way down to South Africa. We had to run from Israel in 70 AD, fleeing from the Romans persecution, man. And that's how we end up in Africa. We're not Africans. We are Hebrew Israelites, man. And let me tell you something. You see all those people that they're shooting down in the United States there, and killing and treating these people like if they're dirt. These people are God people. We are all God chosen children, man. That's the reason why these people are trying to kill us. It's been going on from day one. So as I read these books, man, I'm gathering so much knowledge, man, I'm telling you, and as I listen to the gathering of Christ Church, man, I tell you, I love these brothers. They really know what they're doing. They're doing a lot of research, and just to bring the truth out to us, the truth that was hidden from us for so long, man, since we went into captivity, man. Man, I tell you something. I would never go to these churches again. I don't go to church anymore because they don't tell us who I am. They never tell me who I am. I read into Deuteronomy some time ago, and I discovered that the curses in the Bible, that in Deuteronomy 32, those curses, I've been trying to figure out for the longest while who fit these curses that the Bible talking about here. And the only thing I can come up with, brother, is us. Because we are the only people who was brought to the Americas on slave ships. No other nation, no other people went into captivity. No other people can fit these curses. If you read Deuteronomy 28 and verse 68, you will see what it tells you, man. It tells you that we... Let me read it for you, man. Let me find this. Deuteronomy 28 and 68. Just give me a little chance here. Let me find this to you. I tell you. 68. Okay, here we go. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships, by the way whereof I speak unto thee. Thou shalt see it no more. Let me tell you something. The word Egypt. I don't know if you ever check out the word Egypt. The word Egypt means bondage. Bondage, yes, bondage. We, the black, the colored people, the Negroes that they call in niggers in America. They call we niggers, man. They reduce us down to nothing. And we are the chosen people of the Most High. The Most High choose us. But what happened to us? We disobey our God, man. We disobey our God, and when God put scatters all over the world into these countries, and you know, we became slaves under our enemies, man. These people, God warned us not to have nothing to do with these people, not to intermarry with them, not to do no business with them, not to mix with them, because these people are evil people, and these people, you know, somehow our great grandparents lose it, man, and went and dealing with these people and worshiping the God and forget our God, you know, our God, the Most High. We forget our God and start worshiping the Gentiles' God. And that's why God scattered us into all these foreign lands. That's why we're like how we are, man. It's not the white man did that to us, man. We did that to ourselves. We disobey our Father, and He scatters us into the hands of our enemies. And let me continue reading this thing here. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships, by the way whereof I speak unto thee. Thou shalt see it no more again. That's Israel. we shall see Israel no more again. Where do we live with Israelites, man? Not those people who is over in Israel saying them is Jews. Them is not Jews. They are from Germany and Russia, those people. Those people are the children of fallen angels, man. Fallen angels mixed with mankind, and they produce this thing called Nephilim. They are giants. They were giants before the flood of Noah. You see, remember when I'm gonna continue reading this thing. Thou shalt see it no more again. And there you shall be sold unto your enemies for bondsmen and bondswomen, and no man shall buy you. I believe that word buy means save. No man shall save us. There is no man on earth who is going to get us out of the situation that we are in. But Yeshua. Yeshua, our Savior. He is about to return. This is what's going on. All these wars, the rumors of wars, and the wars that are going on in the Middle East, it's not coincidental. These people are trying to arm the place because they know Christ is about to return. They want to shoot down Christ. All these spaceships and these satellites they're putting out in space and claiming that they're going to try to grow plant on Mars. Who the hell care about growing plant on Mars? We have enough land down here to grow all the plant we need. We don't need nothing, no experiment, no nothing on Mars. We don't belong on Mars. We don't belong on the moon. The moon was placed there to shine the light upon the earth. Mars, you're going to Mars to do what? To look for gold, diamond, to plant plants, to see if plants could grow, to see if man could live out there. Why would you want to live on Mars? Huh? Why would you want to do those things? They're just fooling the people. It's not that. It's weapons. Weapons they're putting out there. Weapons. They want to shoot down Christ because they know Christ is about to return. Don't let them fool you. God is waking up his people all around the world. No man shall buy us. No man, only Yeshua. And let me tell you something. They never tell me who I am in the churches, all the churches that I went. They never tell me who is my God. They tell me I'm a Gentile. But I came to discover that I'm no Gentile at all. I'm not a Gentile. I am the chosen seed of the Most High. Yes. Ahaya, Ahashaba Hashim Ahaya, that's his name. That's my father, the creator of the heavens and of the earth and of all things that liveth in heaven, on earth, and beneath the earth. You're not gonna fool me no longer. Another thing, I've been going through so much hard time in my life. I grew up with no parents in this world. I suffer. I've been working from the age of 11, 12 years old. You know, when I was 12 years old, I was paying $12 a month rent for a one-room apartment. At the age of 12. Didn't get to go to school as these kids nowadays. I have no university degree, no PhD, no nothing. I was self-taught. I learned to read the Bible on my own. That's how I learned. I pick. Everything I get my hands on, I try to read it. Until I realize that this world is not my home. I'm just passing through. But you know what? I read the Bible a lot and I gain a lot of knowledge from the Bible. And I could tell you, the curses that this Bible talking about ain't fit nobody else. No other people, not the Chinese, not the Russians, not the Jewish, not the white man, not, listen to me, man. Let me read a little bit of the curses for you. I'm going back from 32, okay, Deuteronomy 28, verse 30, 15. I'm reading a little bit from 15, okay? But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I commanded thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. Cursed shalt thou be in the city, and cursed shalt thou be in the field. Cursed shalt thou be. Man, it's cursed. All the, that's why we can, everything we try to do, man, it failed. I don't know if you guys noticed. Everything we try to do, we fail. Everything. It doesn't matter what we do. You start a little business, you struggle. Because what? It's not your time. We need to get back to our God. We need to read the Bible and understand what's going on. We need to read the Word of God and check out these things. We are the only people that fit that curse in Deuteronomy.
Are you talking to me?
No.
Talking to
Please
you?
Go inside. I'm doing something here. I wish you guys right now. I wish you guys who go into church every day. You could read the Bible for yourself and stop listening to these dictators who come in on the pulpit and dictating what you should listen to, what you should read, only to get your money to put in the big fat bank account. And you know what? When they take the money to the bank, what happened? What happened when when you give them your money? They take the money and they put it in the big fat bank account. And the bank take that money and lend it to the big conglomerates to do business. And then when you try to go to the bank to get a loan, they refuse you. They tell you your credit is bad. One of the biggest discrimination I see going on around the place is this credit business. You know, they're telling you, oh, you only allow your credit is, credit limit is $2,000 a month or week or whatever the hell it may be. This credit thing is just designed to keep you down, brother. That's why you see me, I try to do something to help myself, because I know the system ain't gonna give me nothing. Right now, look at me. I'm wax old. My hair is turning gray. And I still the same way as when I was born. I have nothing. In a world that's so full of plenty. Could you imagine? You can't just go and take a piece of land and build a house. You have to buy the land from them. Eh? Who give them that power to sell God land to me? Eh? I'm the chosen child of God, and I have no place to rest my head. I had to come and rent apartment and pay an apartment. I cannot go and cut down some trees and build myself a house. I have a woman with children. I've been working my ass off, breaking every bone in my body. This is slavery, man. What can do such a thing to such a people? It's slavery. What can cause a people to lose their heritage, forget who they are, forget their God? Huh? Slavery. We went into captivity because we disobeyed our God. People, you gotta wake up. All you gotta wake up. Everybody today just running after money and lusting after the earthly things, you know. Everybody wanna drive nice car, and everybody wanna live in big house. All these things are gonna come crumbling down someday. The Most High warning the people, waking up the people all over the place. Christ is about to return. Black folks in America, wake up. I am from the tribe of Benjamin. Yes, I am the child of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And you are too.
I am personally really getting tired of being one of the few, if not one of the only, to confront these so-called Black Hebrew Israelites. I feel like that nobody else on YouTube, except for a few other people, is either willing to really confront these Black Israelites, or so-called Black Israelites, or tell them to, in the politest words possible, go take it and shove it.
This is my video response to the fake wannabe so-called Hebrew Israelites. Once and for all, this is going to be the be-all, end-all, game over for this cult, racist group of individuals who are an abomination before God and according to Scripture.
I've heard many of these so-called Hebrew Israelites threatening us, who are, you know, both Black and non-Black, they're gonna enslave the white people and kill the white people and, you know, put us all on ships and when Jesus comes back.
You are not Israel. You teach racism. You teach that the Edomites are evil, when the Scripture says that you must respect and care for the Edomite converts.
It's, hey, cracker must go. Hey, it's, and all kinds of other stuff. And I'm getting scared that it is getting to that point where many Jewish people are going to be affected. In fact, many Jewish people are already being affected. I'm personally really getting tired of being one of the few, if not one of the only, to confront these so-called Black Hebrew Israelites. I feel like that nobody else on YouTube, except for a few other people, is either willing to really confront these Black Israelites, or so-called Black Israelites, or tell them to, in the politest words possible, go take it and shove it. I am getting tired of, I guess, especially in today's world, these people telling us, oh, you're not Jews. If you're white, you're freaking causers. And it's the same kind of stuff that whites, whether they were actually Jewish or not, told a lot of these non-white Jews for so many years. Oh, you're not Jewish because you're not white. And most of the Jewish people really weren't all that dark. They looked more like Syrians and Aramaeans originally, okay? And you guys don't, you know, you're darker than Syrians and Aramaeans and, you know, most Jews nowadays. You know, you're Black or you're African or you're this. So there's no way that you can possibly be Jewish. And now it seems like it's taking the reverse pendulum. It's, oh, if you're not white, you're not Jewish, you're a causer. Well, I'm frankly getting tired of nobody telling these so-called Black Israelites to, again, in the politest words, go take it and shove it, because I see that there are many Jewish people, whether they're white or Black or Asian or Hispanic or whoever they are, they are getting hurt because a couple of people decided to be ethnocentric and say, hey, only this ethnicity is Jewish. Only this ethnicity is Jewish. Only that ethnicity is Jewish. And I have cited scripture so many times saying that there are Jewish people of all ethnicities because of the diaspora, and the Jewish people were originally neither Black, white, Hispanic, Asian, or whatever else you want to call it. They were Middle Eastern, Syrian, Aramaean. And again, one of the reasons I'm trying to get the point across is because I feel that these so-called Israelites are really gaining too much power, too much momentum, too much, you know, whatever you want to call it. But the point is this.
All peoples. I repeat. Listen up, dum-dums. Listen up. You lack wisdom, you lack knowledge, I'm going to give it to you right now. For all peoples, all races, all peoples united under God, God is love.
Yes, love to
Israel.
No, the Chinese.
Israel.
No, the Japanese.
Israel.
No, the white people.
Israel.
The Arabs.
Israel.
So, Israel. Read on.
And forgiveness of sins.
And forgiveness of sins. So only the Israelites can repent and be forgiven of their sins.